Hey babes, Jess here, and welcome to another exciting update for Life with Oral Allergy Syndrome. This is actually my 3-month update on how things are going with allergy shots. So for those of you who are feeling a bit confused, I have what is known as oral allergy syndrome. That is, my body believes I am eating alder when I'm eating a peach. And because the proteins are the same, I have a lovely allergic reaction where my tongue tingles and it's kind of awful. If you'd like to catch up, I have a whole playlist with some links and information on what it's like to have oral allergy syndrome and what I've been doing about it. As for the last 3 months, I have been doing the first set of oral allergy shots where I've actually been getting injections for 9 allergens because I'm allergic to a lot of things. And I've been going twice a week for the last 3 months, and now we have moved into what is known as the maintenance phase where I'm going once a week. I'll be going once a week for quite a while we continue to increase my dosage, and then we will begin to decrease the number of times I go. This is a 3 to 5 year process depending on how things go, and I'm pretty excited to be out of the most active part of it. But for those of you who are considering going for allergy shots or feeling nervous, I'm hoping this can clear things up for you a little, because there's a lot that happens and most of it becomes routine. So with that, let's dive in. First, I feel like the most important part, I am technically still not allowed to test my allergies. I mainly work with allergy technicians who are awesome, and they've been coordinating with the doctor, but they'd really like me to not do any aggressive self-testing yet because we're still not out of maintenance phase 1. That being said, I did completely accidentally eat a whole pint of strawberries while I was hungry a few days ago, and it went fine. I told my allergy team, they said, please don't do that again. And also strawberries were very low risk for me, so it wasn't like me eating peaches, which is my worst, but it went okay. So fingers crossed that I can maybe try peaches this summer. We'll see. Second, it becomes routine really fast. You go in to get your shot, you wait, they check it over, you leave, and you see them in a few days. And honestly, that helped a lot more than I expected, because it was just this nice thing where just, okay, I'm doing it. It's not really anything I anticipate or get nervous over at this point. It's just, okay, I need to relax my arm enough now so I can actually do this, because having a very relaxed arm is very important to the injection process. Oh my goodness. 3, injection pain varies a lot. On average, it hurts less than a flu shot. I explained this in a previous video that the needles are smaller than a flu shot needle, and that's great just because the amount and concentration of fluid you're getting injected with varies each week. The amount of pain varies from that. The actual injection doesn't hurt for very long. For me, it's never hurt more than a couple minutes, but then it starts to itch and swell, and I've had like swellings like this big on my arm and can't sleep because of them. So that amount of swelling and itchiness and pain has varied more than the actual pain from the injection. And the more I can relax my arm, the better things go. And it usually really only like sting hurts still for like 30 seconds on average. That's nice. And I will say that the maintenance shots, they hurt worse. They do, because that's undiluted. And that one hurt the worst out of all the shots I've done so far. And it still wasn't that bad. It was just surprising that it hurt that much. 4, there are a number of tricks they can use to make injections hurt less, to make the pain from swelling go away. That's pretty awesome. For one thing, they can give you ibuprofen. They can add on Benadryl to your regimen. These are things you should definitely talk out with your allergy team. But for me, we've been doing 400 milligrams of ibuprofen before and after, and that does help a lot. And also, they can sometimes split the injection. Yeah, it means that sometimes one arm itches more, but on the average, I found that splitting the injection is less awful than having one shot in one arm. And that's a big help sometimes. Number 5, you can take breaks. So when I started on oral allergy shots, I thought I was going to be in like the tightest, most strict regimen, and I had to travel a few days after I started, and I was getting really antsy. And again, this is a check with your care team first, but generally I found more flexibility in the shot procedure than I expected. They do want you to be on time and as scheduled as possible, but like during the snow, I was out for 2 weeks between being trapped in the snow and ill, and it only set me back one injection. So that was pretty awesome. That was 2 weeks in between shots and I was just one behind. And like the other day I had to reschedule what day of the week I come in for shots, and that was no problem. That was a 2 day shift. So if you're worried that like, oh my gosh, every Friday to the end of time is ruined, fear not, it's gonna be okay. Number six, with working with a walk-in allergy clinic, it's pretty awesome to have flexibility, but everyone else is using that too, so your wait time varies. I could go at the same time every single week and have a different wait time because everyone else is on different schedules. So I try to give myself an hour on site, and I try to make sure that I'm there well before when the clinic closes so that I'm not rushing. But generally I've been on site like no more than a 15 minute wait. So that's been nice. They're really good about getting people in and out, and they're aware of how long you're trying to wait. Like really it's worse waiting for the injection timer to go off, because you have to wait 30 minutes before you can leave, than the actual waiting to get the injection at this point. Because 30 minutes of itching is just kind of boring. Number seven, travel with an EpiPen is really a non-issue. When I was doing my first bit of travel with the EpiPen, I was nervous. Like, oh, I'd forgotten my prescription information. I was freaking out because my first time traveling with it, and I'm like, oh my goodness. And I remember to check that you're supposed to declare that you have the EpiPen because, you know, it's got a needle. And they seemed kind of annoyed with me that I was declaring the EpiPen, of all things. Honestly, TSA seemed more annoyed with wanting to get me to pull out my e-reader than it did about the EpiPens. I do think, clearly, like, bring your prescription case if you have it. That's a good thing to have. It was just, I thought it was gonna be far more of an event, that they'd want to pull it out and look at my EpiPen, and they didn't. That was kind of a relief. Number eight. On the other hand, caring for an EpiPen is kind of annoying. So something they don't tell you when you get the EpiPen is in the fine print, it has a fairly narrow range of temperatures. I believe it's 59 to 79 degrees Fahrenheit. I'll put the actual numbers on the screen and in Celsius, but it's narrow. I live in Seattle. We haven't seen above 50 in weeks. And so I have my little insulated case, but this thing's kind of not that great insulation. Like you can see, it's really more meant for someone carrying a diabetes case. And I mean, it's nice and all, like, that it has instructions, but one, it's not that great insulation. And two, I feel like you can't really tell that it's a medical device. Like, yeah, it has this guy, but no one's trained to spot orange. Like, I could not find a medical red insulated EpiPen case that I liked anywhere on the market. I've been half joking that I need to make a purse with an EpiPen side so I can fix this, and it turns out that one doesn't exist. Like, there's diabetes purses and there's kind of EpiPen purse, but it's like this big and it's horrible and it's a little crossbody and it's meant for people who don't carry their lives in their bag, and I am not one of those people. So at this rate, I will be designing a purse for EpiPen carriers because I can't take it anymore. But the problem is, at the end of the day, this is, you know, life saving technology, and I want these little guys to be safe and usable, you know? I need to be able to rely on these, so it's nerve-wracking. Also, I've been slowly disclosing to friends that I'm carrying it, and I have realized that a lot of people don't know how to use an EpiPen. Please know how to use an EpiPen. This is an important skill that might save your friend's life or your family member's life or your life. So please Google how to use an EpiPen. Thank you. So that is my 3 month update on life with oral allergy syndrome and with being on allergy shots. I would love to hear from you awesome peeps in those comments below. Are you on allergy shots? Have you been considering allergy shots? I hope this helped out, but if you have any more questions, please ask away. I'm not a medical professional, but I can probably help you get some information. And with that, I will catch you in the next video. Laters!